Do not buy an XP-PEN G640 in 2020, and let me tell you why. A Reddit post made a month ago tells you that XP-PEN has released a new version of the XP-PEN G640, which in this post is going to be called Revision B, or Rev B, compared to Rev A, which is the first XP-PEN G640. Why is this bad? Isn't this actually a good thing? No. They've actually made it worse, and I'll summarise why. The new revision Rev B has a lower pixel perfect resolution. For example, in Rev A you can make your area as small as 9.26mm by 5.48mm on a 1080p monitor, and it will still be pixel perfect. However, with Rev B, the pixel perfect area has literally doubled in length and width. The smallest area you can play with now is 18.53mm by 10.97mm with pixel perfect accuracy. Fortunately, this won't be an issue for most of us, unless you plan to play OSU with an area of less than 2cm in width or length. If any of you are doing that, I'll actually be amazed. The main issue with this new revision is its decreased polling rate from 266Hz found in Rev A to around 200Hz in this new revision. Put simply, polling rate, or RPS, which stands for report rate speed, measures how many times per second the tablet sends information back to the computer. Therefore, the higher the polling rate, the greater the responsiveness. By reducing the polling rate of the tablet, the less responsive the tablet will be, so the movement on the screen will be less accurate to the movement of the pen in real life, almost like a delay in the movement. The difference may not seem like a lot, but I suppose any extra responsiveness is beneficial. And now the final change that is really the most important one to cover is that it now has a lot of hardware smoothing. That means that any movement on the tablet is smoothened, so you do not get accurate representations of your movement from real life with the pen to the cursor on the screen. This is a huge problem because you will not get raw input, and it could lead you to misaiming because your cursor may just drift a few pixels or millimeters just to try and smoothen the cursor experience. It's great for drawing, but not great for OSU. XP-PEN is supposed to be known for not having bad or any hardware smoothening. Unfortunately, this is not able to be fixed by software, such as tablet drivers, because the smoothing is built in the tablet hardware itself. And finally, the biggest issue with this change of the XP-PEN G640 is that the changes are not documented. Go to their main website, xppen.com, and its report rate is noted as 266. Go to Amazon, and it also states that it's 266. But the reality is that these new revisions have a 200Hz polling rate instead. In fact, it doesn't even mention that there's a change in the product. It doesn't even say that this is version 2. All of these changes actually make this new revision a completely different tablet. You are no longer looking at this product as a cheap but good tablet. You are looking at it now as an expensive shit tablet, so please do not buy it, and consider buying another tablet around the price range. I may leave some suggestions in the description below. So how do I check if I've got this new revision or not? If you've purchased one in May, June, or later this year, it's very likely that you have the shit version. To check it fully, you'll have to download Hawku's drivers, or any Hawku related driver. Links will be in the description below. I will not be walking through on how to set up tablet drivers. I might make a short video on it another time. Go to the console tab and type in HID list. It will show all hardware devices connected or associated with your computer. So find the XP-PEN star G640 and look up product ID. It will be 0094 for revision A, the good tablet, or 0914 for revision B, the bad one, and I pray that you see 0094. Otherwise, I'm actually very sorry about your purchase. You've basically been scammed. In fact, if the tablet doesn't even work with your tablet drivers, it might be because you have the new version, and the way to fix it,
it's to toss it in the bin.
If you still want to use it, and please don't use it, you'll have to open up the tablet config file and paste in this text. The link will be in the description down below. Hopefully that will solve the problem. And I don't actually know if tablet drivers at the moment support this new revision, so maybe you didn't need to do this step. Final conclusion. Please do not purchase this trash revision of the tablet, and look at other possible products instead. Thanks a lot for watching, have a great day.
It's time to cue that epic outro.